Hey, hello. I will try to show you how to make unarmed build and how to use exploit I found. Well, just to have it ready in case if I fuck up recording or something. By the way, finding this resolution solution took me fucking eternity. Yeah, I know it looks horrendous for most users because it is not as polished. Right, this should be good enough. Power of 10 agility allow you to avoid a lot of combat. Anyway, pause and we see each other later when I resolve dungeon trial. Escaping dungeon without combat grants you. Grants you more XP than combat. And since I didn't kill anything yet, I am leaning towards escaping without combat. Good. We need as many as possible in that department. Please fix well. We are not very good at fixing, but here. Healing powder is very good currency. I have 4 right now if I would kill garden plants. Okay, let's go. It's very important to not step on the acid. In some versions, your character like is kind of lead to step on acid. Smoke was hit for 1 damage. Yeah, so he step on acid. Fuck him. He have enough HP to sustain himself even if he step on acid. Good doggo is back to its owner. So, I always recommend people to go Klamath. Because it's make entire thing easier if you do anything in Klamath. Not just skip to then. Okay, this is Trapper Town. This is one of the important things. This is where you save. Okay, this is second important thing. One moment. If you take this flask, you need only one. And they take some weight. So my advice is always take only one. There you can get extremely important radio part and gun. I don't need any help, by the way. I cannot wait to fight fucking Red Scorpion. Definitely. Oh, this is good. Because I'm Jinx character, so that means a character who is in my presence. Are more likely to drop weapons. Honestly, this is okay trade. Okay, so first important part is den. In the den, you need both out. Both out can be sometimes purchased from this person. Not this time. There's the ghost. Okay, here's safe. First buff out can be found on cemetery, and this is almost mandatory. Here. Second grave in the corner. Now, sadly, this is as far as I can go right now. This is a huge roadblock to require from player so much fucking money so early. Not a big fan of this shit. Anyway, let me show you where you can get a second. I don't have food. I sold all my jerky and give one to dog. Okay, so this is my dog. You move this to be able to install a rope here later when you find rope. But most important, here is second buff out for you. I don't know where exactly, but there is. Okay, this guy is also a trader. Okay, out. No idea who to sell Brahim to this guy. But yeah, when you have double buff out, save before traveling and going all the way back to Arayo. Holy hell. Wait, I have new weapon. This is a typical encounter, you cannot do anything here. It's gonna occur randomly as one of the random encounters. It probably meant to show brutality of the antagonist and his size compared to any other fucking normal person. Okay, so when you are near head guy, I will show you the trick. So you need to save. And you need to eat poof out. This makes you very strong and very durable for a very short time. Now question is how you wait from here. Because you need to wait now. But I wonder how long. I think it's 4 hours only. To get withdrawal, right? No. It's not 4 hours. Okay. It's not 5 hours. Oh fuck, it's 6 hours, right? Yes. So now you need to improve your unarmed to 40 and also agility. If your agility is 6, overloaded. Minor inconvenience, I think. Yes, minor inconvenience, but still need to get head guy to train you. First you go to head guy, and second if you get lucky to Cameron. Sadly no, we restored stats to normal. But we have 71 unarmed for free. And this is the double buff out trick. Wait 6 hours on double buff out to kick with Drava and then train to get plus 15, which will be compensated later. Normally I would get plus 5, thanks to this method I get plus 15. I only spend 6 points.